Nigel. I haven't got a nice word to say about him. He's definitely in the top three most disturbed individuals that I've ever worked with.
Well, what have I done? What did I do, Rob? I took you out of Stoke-on-Trent. God, there's one thing I did for him. And I made him massive. And look at him now. Look where he is now.
He thought I could do a job. You know, I it wasn't a charitable event.
I'm very, very proud of the part I played in his success.
There was no, you know, we'll pick him from Stoke in Tunstall, 'cause he looks as though he needs it. You know, I made him money.
Yes, I did sue him at the end of Take That. I sued him because he owed me 200 grand in commission.
And he would say, yeah, I picked him and I don't get any credit for that. He picked me because I was good.
I gave him his career as far as I'm concerned.
If it hadn't have been him who'd have found me, it'd have been somebody else.
Rubbish. I mean, you know, I've heard Robbie has been referring to the various members of Take That as casualties from Take That.
He's really failed himself in this lifetime.
Robbie Williams, from the life of 17, has travelled the world first class, stayed in hotels. He's worth millions. He's a very lucky young lad. Don't talk to me about casualties, Robbie. It's sick.
I only wanted him to love me. You know, that's the sad, really sad thing. You know, I only wanted him to love me. And he never did.
I never told anybody this. I was seriously thinking of jumping in the Thames, thinking I wanted to kill myself. We'd pulled it together and we did it ourselves. We did it with the four of us.
We'd had the stages made. We were deep in investment basically in these shows. We had to do them.
There was a risk of this concert that was coming up. Half of the people weren't going to be there.
That first night that we walked on that stage, you know, we didn't know what the reaction was going to be. We didn't know how that was going to go.
I mean, we kept at it. Nothing stopped for us.
I knew it wasn't the same. I knew it wasn't the same.
And when you rise, the main feeling was I was just getting carried away with the drama of it, just enjoying the drama and the attention more than anything. It almost didn't feel like the end.
We all went on holiday at Christmas, and that's when the band ended.
We always said, you know, go out with a number one. And, you know, 6 years on, it was getting hard. It wasn't fun anymore. And it's me you need to show. How deep is your love?
Just say thanks for everybody's support in the last 5 years. You've been absolutely fantastic to us, but unfortunately the rumours are true. How Deep Is Your Love is going to be our last single together, and The Greatest Hits is going to be our last album, and from today
is no more.
So there you go.
Thank you.
After months of speculation, the news that every Take That fan had been dreaded.
One of the most popular bands of the 90s,
with many of the young fans on
they just split up after 3 years of success, including 7 number one hits. I believe in you. You know you're the door to my bare soul.
You're the light in my deepest dark. From our point of view,
interview him from him. I mean, it's very hard because we've worked with these guys for 5 years, and we talk about it.
You watched them grow up.
We got to grow up from kids to men.
I just spent the day in my room. It was horrible.
It still upsets me, and I mean, you can see I'm nearly crying. It just upsets me.
I've never seen anything that comes close to the guys.
Yeah. I thought my world had ended. I didn't see any way out of it. I was probably crying for about 2 weeks.
I suppose in and amongst all the feelings, there was a feeling of relief. It's over.
No regrets, no thinking, oh, let's do a little bit more. For me, it was like best news of the year so far.
Did I feel ready? No, I didn't. But it was time.
That's it for Take That and for us too. I hope you'll join us again tomorrow. From all of us here at ITN, good night.
The only one that didn't want to call it a day was Howard, who just sat there, you know, in floods of tears saying, no, let's carry on. You know, I don't want to stop this. I'm loving it.
I just wasn't ready for it finishing. Out of everybody, I wasn't ready for it. And I didn't want it to finish. I was really disappointed. I must have been emotional and tired about what was happening. I already knew that the group was going to finish. And I decided to walk out the hotel and go to the Thames. The state of my mind at that time, I never told anybody this, I was seriously thinking of jumping in the Thames, thinking I wanted to kill myself, but I'm just too much of a shitbag to do it.
Howard was going to commit suicide. That is frightening, that. That is really shocking. I never knew that.